Anh Hưng xin kính chào quý vị và một lần nữa xin chào đón quý vị đến chương trình Bảo hiểm và Tài chánh. Kính thưa quý vị, trong những chương trình trước, anh Hưng có mời được cô Melody Avesia, giám đốc của công ty Runway Hills. Và trong chương trình trước thì cô có bật mí cho chúng ta biết về một đôi giày mà có thể đổi từ thấp lên cao và từ cao xuống thấp bằng một bấm nút. Dạ, kính thưa quý vị, hôm nay từ một ý tưởng đó nó đã trở thành sự thật và chúng ta đã thấy đôi giày đó đang trước mặt của chúng ta. Melody.
Hey.
So glad to have you back on the show.
Thank you for having me. Happy to be here.
Yes, and it's so exciting because when you were here the first time, we talked about concept and you were busy inventing the shoes that most of us women are excited to see. And now it is becoming a reality.
Exactly. So it's been a 4-year journey actually from conception to actually having the product. So we're truly excited to have the product here. So it's a fun, challenging, tedious journey to actually have this world's first patented push button retractable high heels. So it basically changes from high heels to flats with just a push of a button.
Yep, and you can see I'm all smiles because with all the travel that I do,
exactly.
I am so excited that I'm able to carry one pair of shoes and being able to do both. It looks sexy and then elegant, and then at the same time being able to go anywhere just with a push of a button.
Exactly, so having that comfort, the versatility, and the convenience in one.
And with that, I do want to kind of revisit that journey because I know it is not as simple as what meets the eyes. I know that this concept has been thought of and many people attempt to make it work for many, many years. And I never realized how complicated it would be to engineer. The word is to engineer a pair of shoes that can do this. And so if you could share with us that technology.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so basically it's really the fusion of art and science. We have the best craftsmen actually here in Los Angeles and the best engineers in Silicon Valley that collaborated to bring this product into fruition. And you mentioned about challenges. It's truly one challenge after another. From local craftsmen basically saying, no, it can't be done, mm-hmm. to Hollywood shoemakers who have done props for Hollywood movies, who have the budget, who have the expertise, or so they thought, to come up with something like this for this actually very popular movie. And the Hollywood shoemaker that actually was commissioned to do the project told me, Melody, I'm gonna save you the heartache and the cost and whatnot. I tried it personally, had I think 6 months. It was 6 months for him to come up with a project, and he said it can't be done. It was supposed to be Uma Thurman, so a big Hollywood celebrity that was supposed to wear a shoe similar to this. Mm-hmm. So he said no. Local shoe craftsman said no, went to New York, mm-hmm. and did a whole week of intense shoemaking class, met with Italian shoemakers who have been doing shoemaking for his family, for generations. All of them were saying no. And thus, I thought, you know, if they're all saying no, I have to respect that, and then just literally pivot and look at another source. And that's when I pretty much thought of having not shoemakers, but engineers to help with the solution.
So what was complicated about it? What was so hard that caused it to not come into fruition for other?
Actually, that's a very good question. There is a saying in shoemaking where the last comes first. Last is a term for the mold. And mold, as we know, is a fixed object where you have something that is permanent. So the last is first, so you come up with a last before you have the shoe. And since it's permanent, it doesn't really move and it's not as flexible. It can't really pivot, it can't really adjust to the height. So that was the first problem that a lot of people have tried. And since they have been, you know, it's challenge after challenge to come up with the last that actually bends. So that's the first one. And then the second would be coming up with something that is aesthetically, you know, classic, pleasing, and still have that function. So there's that challenge. And to have a technology that would just be convenient, where you don't have to have another pair of heel that you could detach, or there's one out there that you have to pull-push
right.
technology. And we thought that it's not that hygienic, to basically touch the part of the heel that touches the pavement, mm-hmm. So this is really, truly one of a kind, and we're very excited and proud.
So let's show our audience how it works. Let's grab that shoe, and you can share.
So it's very simple, and it's really easy. All it is you push the button, it loosens the mechanism inside, and then you retract it from high heels to flats, and it gets into this cavity and it becomes flats. And then if you need to change it into high heels, just press the button again, and voila.
And look at that style. So how many style are we introducing?
So the introductory styles that we have are actually five, and they are all mindfully classic design by nature. And now we are excited to showcase the bridal collection. Oh. So the first one is actually out, and we have two more to go. So maybe
there.
We can flash that later.
So exciting, absolutely. So what's next for Runway? What's the next project?
So aside from having to complete the bridal collection, we are currently in talks with several foreign companies that want to launch and introduce Runway to several countries. As we speak, I was actually just texting the contact in Japan. So we have Japanese companies that wish to do the marketing for the local market and introduce Runway there. We have Singaporean companies and one in Uruguay, and Chinese market as well, that have expressed interest. So that's kind of where our head is at right now.
And I know Runway Heels is catching a lot of attention out there right now. And I know that you've been invited on multiple shows, not just in the United States, but you are getting attention internationally. Am I correct?
Internationally, mm-hmm. Yes. So we're surprised, actually, is the word. I really was just looking for a solution. It's an age-old solution that us women and women in our lives that have experience, really seriously for generations. So I was just really more into coming up with a solution. Little did I know that it'll have this momentum, this traction. So I'm pleasantly surprised with that. So we did a segment with in London radio, Colombian radio station, and a lot of media attention in newspaper. Uh-huh. So it's all good.
Well, and so of course that takes me into something that our show is all about, entrepreneurship.
Yes.
And more importantly, a woman starting a business and launching it and taking it to the next level. Mm-hmm. I know that this is not your only venture. That you are a very successful businesswoman, and you are able to, you have businesses that are multi-million dollars that you're running right now as well. With people watching us, watching you, this exciting venture that you are starting, and we are lucky enough to see you from the beginning of that, what advice can you give to our new entrepreneur that want to pick an idea and have it launch and be able to have support? I know you had to deal with finance, with engineering, with production and marketing and all that. What can you give to our audience?
Well, if it's just maybe a one line, it's really shoot for the moon, and if you miss, you land amongst the stars. So don't be afraid to take the risk and take it one step at a time. It's daunting if you just think of how to reach from point A to point B, but if you're not really looking towards that huge space out there and that unknown, and you're just taking it one day at a time, I think that would be key. And just having faith and having that belief in yourself, if you know that you would put the time, energy, effort, and have that mindset of not giving up, I think that's all going to pan out somehow later on. And you mentioned entrepreneurship. I think the beauty of entrepreneurship is, you know, you're not just stuck with just one. You know, as you mentioned, we're blessed to have have this multi-line insurance agency, which is still my passion, a very good industry, which I feel I'm very good at. Enjoy the, you know, having the team building and all the good components of that industry, but that shouldn't stop anyone, you know? And again, the beauty is if there's something else that tickles your fancy and that you want to solve a problem, then it's out there. And it's also part of, I think, the culture now, and it's so global. And with this product, proud to say that it's really a collaboration of different hands that have contributed to this one. We have Korea for the heels, we have Mexico for the uppers, we have Italy for the shank, LA for the brains that started it, plus the assembly. So it's very global.
Awesome. So, Melody, any if our audience wants to order these shoes, tell them how we can get them.
Yes, please visit our website. It's www.runwayheels.com. And if you're on Instagram, it's at Runway Heels. We're also on Facebook. So see you there. Thank you, Theresa.
You're welcome. And there you go, the beautiful Melody Avasia, knowing how to create beautiful shoes for our feet. Kính thưa quý vị, nhất là các bạn gái của Ánh Hương, như quý vị thấy, cô Melody đã tạo nên cho chúng ta một đôi giày vừa đẹp mà vừa có sự hữu hiệu. Nếu quý vị muốn xem nhiều kiểu đẹp kế tiếp nữa, thì xin quý vị tiếp tục theo cô Melody Avasia trong www.runwayheels.com.
You got it.
Xin kính chào quý vị.
See you.